Jimmy Fallon and Stephen Colbert discuss the problems facing the president and his latest feud with Canada. Late-night hosts discussed Donald Trump's barrage of problems as he reached his landmark 100th day in office. On The Late Show, Stephen Colbert brought up Trump's latest feud with Canada, which he jokingly referred to as Cold Mexico and the Great White North Korea. The problems stem from Trump insisting Canada pays high tariffs on the lumber it exports to the U.S. As far as I know, this is the first time anyone has rejected Justin Trudeau's wood, he said. He then joked, Trump is now a friend of Putin and an enemy of Putin. Colbert also discussed Ivanka Trump's disastrous trip to Germany, noting that her father has yet to travel abroad since he came to power. Since becoming president, Donald Trump has not left the country. He has barely left the country club, he said. She attended a women's conference in Germany, which led Colbert to call her the first Trump to attend a women's conference that didn't include a swimsuit competition. The event was aimed at inspiring women. Colbert joked, the Trump family has a long history of inspiring women, to march, to sue, to flee from a dressing room. On The Daily Show, Trevor Noah received a surprise visitor, Donald Trump. Well, Anthony Daimonerk in character as Trump to support his new Comedy Central series, The President's Show. Talking about how to pay for the wall between the U.S. and Mexico, he said it was simple. Totally and completely easy, it is not complicated at all, he said. This is easy stuff people, totally easy. We can tax them, they don't have to pay with money, we can tax them. He continued, we re going to bring millions and millions of Mexicans into the United States and let them do the low-paying jobs that Americans want to do, and we re going to save so much money and we can use it to pay for the wall. After touching Noah's suit, he joked, my God, I have pillows with a higher threat count. On Late Night with Seth Meyers, the host covered Trump's speech for Holocaust Remembrance Day. He reminded the crowd that we must never forget the 6 million people who attended his inauguration, Meyers said. There was confusion and derision online on Tuesday over Trump's strange pronunciation of the word Nazi. Is it weird that I am a little relieved he don't know how to say Nazi? He said. He also brought up confusion over the wall. First Mexico was going to pay for it, then we were going to pay for it, now nobody is going to pay for it. On The Tonight Show, Jimmy Fallon played a game listing the pros and cons of Trump's first 100 days. He started by saying, pro, 100 days. Con. 99 problem.